the last video you have also discussed about the properties of the triangle, and I told you that the property of the triangle is also known as the fact of the triangle or the theorem of the triangle. Okay? And in my last video I told you that two property of triangle, and they were generally that the first property is that the sum of all angles, the sum of all angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Okay, I was told you about this, and I told you that the one angle two angle three is equal to 180 degrees, and the next was the exterior angle. The exterior angle is equal to the sum of opposite interior angle. Okay, or mathematically angle 4 is equal to angle 2 plus angle 3. Okay, these were the two properties of the triangle that we have discussed in our previous lecture, and today we shall discuss about the altitude and the median of our triangle, and after that we shall start our exercise and we shall try to solve some questions from the exercise. So let us see what are the median and altitude. Not altitude, median and altitude. So let us see what is the median. So first of all, let me draw a triangle. Here we have a triangle ABC, and find out its midpoint, the midpoint of the BC. The midpoint of the BC is this named D. Okay? And a line segment which joins to the midpoint of the opposite side of the triangle from a vertex is called its median. A median is a line segment which join the midpoint of the opposite side of a vertex is called its median. In this figure we can see that the opposite side of the vertex A is BC, and D is the midpoint of the line segment BC, and when we join the vertex A to the point B, then we get AD is the median. Then AD is the median. Here we can see that a triangle has three lines in it, and if it has three lines in it, then the triangle also has three median. Okay. Now let us see. The next is, suppose that the midpoint of the line segment AC is E and joins the point E to your vertex B, then BE is also a median of the triangle ABC. Similarly, this is the point F, which is the midpoint of the line segment AB, and after drawing this point to the vertex C, then we get CF is the median. So here we get that a line segment which joins the midpoint of the opposite side to the vertex is called median of a triangle. And here we can see that the point O, where all these three medians are intersect, is known as median point. Median point on vertex. Okay, so we define that a line segment which joins the vertex to the opposite side is called its median. And here we have defined the median by the figure. Okay, I hope that is clear to all. Now let us see our next topic, that is the altitude of triangle. So let us see what is the altitude of the triangle. Altitude, the meaning of altitude is height. Okay, so the altitude of a triangle means height of the triangle. So first of all, let me draw a figure. Here we have the triangle. Angle A, B, C. There is a triangle A, B, C. Now we have to find out the height of the triangle. The height of the triangle means the perpendicular distance of the triangle. So here we can see that the perpendicular distance is this. The perpendicular distance from the vertex to the opposite side is called its height or altitude of the triangle. So here we get AD is the altitude of triangle. Okay, and this is denoted by the small letter of H. So it is called its height or altitude. So we define that the perpendicular distance from the vertex to the opposite side is called its altitude. I hope it is clear to us what is the altitude. In easy manner, we can say that altitude is the height of the triangle. And if we consider the height, then here we have to find out the perpendicular distance from the vertex to the opposite side. This called its altitude. So I hope that there is no doubt in this topic. Now let's start our exercise. So let us see what is the question. There is a question. In an isosceles, in an isosceles triangle, one of the angle is 120 degrees. One of the angle is 120 degrees. Can find the other angle. So this is the question. In an isosceles triangle, one angle is of 120 degrees, then we have to find out its remaining two angles. For this, first of all, let us draw our isosceles triangle. This is an, this is not an isosceles triangle. So first of all, let me draw an isosceles triangle. This is the one which is shown on the 30 degrees. So for this, this is a triangle A, B, C, and in this figure the line segment AD is equal to the line segment BC. So here we write solution. Since the triangle is isosceles, therefore AB is equal to BC. And we know that if the opposite sides are equal, then the angles are also equal. Therefore, let us suppose that the angles are X. Because the sides are equal, therefore the opposite angles are also equal. So if we consider the one angle is X, then its other angle is also X. So here we get also angle BAC is equal to the angle BCA, and this is equal to X. Okay? And one more thing, we know that the sum of all angle of angle is equal to 180 degrees. Therefore, by first property of angle, we get X plus 120 degrees is equal to 180 degrees. Or this is equal to 2X plus 120 degrees is equal to 180 degrees. Now it becomes a linear equation in one variable, and you know how to solve this. So we get 2X is equal to 180 minus 120, which implies 2x is equal to 60 degrees, or x is equal to 60 upon 2, which gives x is equal to 30 degrees. Therefore, the value of these two angles are of 30 degrees. Okay? I hope it is clear to all. So, I think there will be no doubt in this problem. If you have any doubt, then you can comment your doubt. I will try to clear your doubt in the next video. Now let us see one more question from the same exercise, and let us see what is that. Find the sum of four angles of the quadrilateral ABC. Find the sum of four angles of quadrilateral. Okay, so for that, let us draw a quadrilateral ABC. This is the quadrilateral ABCD, and now we have to find out the sum of all its angles. But here we know about the sum of all angles for the triangle, not for a quadrilateral. So in order to find out the sum of all angles of a quadrilateral, first of all we have to resolve this quadrilateral into a triangle. For this, let us draw a diagonal of this triangle, of this quadrilateral, so that the line which divides a quadrilateral into two triangles is called its diagonal. So here we get two triangles ABC and ABC. So in the solution we write, here we have triangle ABC and triangle ABC are two triangles, and we know that sum of all angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Therefore, let us see what are the three angles of triangle ABC. Is CAD, this is the first angle. CAD is the first, ADC is the second angle, and ACD is the third. Therefore we write angle CAD, you can write only one letter of the angle, plus angle ABC plus angle ACD is equal to 180 degrees. Make it equation number 1. Okay, so here we get the sum of all angles of the triangle ADC is 180 degrees. Similarly, we can write this fact for the triangle ABC also. And angle A B C plus angle B C A plus angle C A D is equal to 180 degrees. Then this is question number 2. So here we get two equations which are listed here, and here we have to find out the sum of all angles of this quadrilateral. So when we draw its diagonal, our quadrilateral is divided into two triangles. So when we add these two triangles, we get a complete quadrilateral, and therefore if we add all its angles, then we get the sum of all interior angles of the quadrilateral. So when we add these two, we get our required result. So let us see. We write here, on adding equation 1 and 2, equation 1 and 2, we get, when we add them, then we get angle. I have erased the figure, so I write directly angle ABC, angle ABC plus angle BCD plus angle CDA plus angle BAB is equal to 180 degrees plus 180 degrees, and is equal to 360 degrees, which is the required result for this question. Okay, I have write this step directly because when we add them, then at last we get this line. Okay, therefore this is the required result. I hope it is clear to all, and if you have any doubt in this problem, then you can ask me as a comment. I will clear your comment in my next video. So thank you very much for watching.